All right, people, so I've pretty much taken temperature readings all over the yard. We've got thermometers set up right now. We're gonna figure out just how cold it's gonna get here in my yard tonight. As of tonight, Sunday night, Monday morning, it's gonna get really cold. It's expecting about 8 degrees, I think, is the current forecast right now. But it's super windy. I don't know if you guys can hear that because I have a dead cat on the microphone, but it is very windy. The winds are gonna be, somewhere between 15 and 20 miles per hour all night. And what that's gonna create is that 8 degree low is gonna be much worse. The wind chill is gonna be way worse than 8 degrees. So what does that mean for figs? I don't really know yet. We're gonna find out. You know, this whole winter experiment has been an experiment. You know, we're gonna see just how cold these figs can reach at the soil level, above ground as well. And we'll know about a month from now if this particular day, because this is gonna be the coldest day, if this day had a great impact on these trees. So far, I've evaluated all the in-ground trees as they are right now. So far, it looks like my Italian 258 here and my Figo Preto, which are both very young trees. A lot of their growth was quite vigorous at the end of the season, which is not what you want. And these trees took a really big hit on Thanksgiving night, when we got down to 13 degrees, and that was very early for that temperature here in this area. It's on record. So because we got to that crazy low, they took a lot of damage. But every other tree, I've inspected them, whether they're in this location here, in this raised bed area over here. We have some along the house, which includes Ronde Bordeaux, Little Ruby, Colonel Lippman's Black Cross. We have a Hardy Chicago right there that looks stunning. We also have a White Marseille in this raised bed, right? We're also evaluating how high we can plant these, and that's why I want to take soil temperature readings. I'm more interested in the soil temperature, honestly, than the air temperature, but we're going to compare the air temperature to the soil temperature. I know there's formulas you can do that are pretty accurate. You can kind of guesstimate. Based off the air temperature, you can kind of come up with a decent soil temperature. You see how windy it is right now, especially in this little corridor. This here is Taramo Unknown. None of these trees are showing any signs of dieback. Even the trees out in the front in the open, we have Malta Black out there, Peru Celeste. We have another Hardy Chicago type out there. This guy is planted in a raised bed. And we're going to see if this 8 degree low, how cold the soil gets, and see if the root systems of these trees can handle it. And if they can't handle it, we'll know come spring. Because if the entire tree is dead, the root system got too cold. It took damage and it died. Now, if the trees are taking damage on their wood, you know, as of tonight, we get down to that 8 degree low, I'll know a month from now if these trees are showing any damage. And if they are on their wood, we'll know that that 8 degree low was the reason, and not so much on the form of desiccation. If these trees get through this 8 degree low, I think it's pretty much smooth sailing from here. There's not going to be too many cold nights from this point on. This is on average the coldest week or coldest weeks on average of the year in my area. And it is for most people throughout the country. It may have already happened for you, but for me, this is the coldest week of the year. And if we're only getting down to 8 degrees, that's actually quite mild, because normally we get down to zero. But we've had a couple winters there in a row that we got down to zero quite often. So this may just be one of those normal winters now that we're going back to, that things don't get nearly as cold. So we'll see if that cold knocks them back, and if it doesn't and the root systems seem fine, right? We took the soil temperature readings. That temperature is above 17 degrees Fahrenheit. We're okay. But if for whatever reason, we get then into March, we get then into April, we get then into May, and the tree is looking real sad, it's not gonna wake up, it looks dead, or the tree, I'm sorry, if we get to that portion of the year and the tree looks like all the branches have died back to the ground, then it's not the cold. We know it's not the cold because a month after, what is today, January 20th or something like that? I'm losing track of the date here, guys. It's Sunday. I don't really care for the date, but let's say it's January 20th. A month from now, February 20th, we'll know that, okay, there's no dieback from that point. It wasn't the cold. It wasn't that 8-degree low that we know. And all right, we'll give it a little bit more time than a month. Let's say 2 months. We'll say by March. But if our trees look fine in March, they're probably going to look fine in May. But historically, they haven't. And that's where the wilt-proof protection comes in, the anti-desiccant that I'm using to protect these trees. Now, I want to go over the soil temperature because I'm not going to be out here at probably like, I think it's like 2 a.m. that it's going to be the lowest, or 3 a.m. or something like that. I'm not going to be out here filming for you guys. It's going to be dark. You're not going to be able to see anything. I'm going to be freezing. I want to take the soil temperature readings and go in, back inside. You know what I mean? We've got here thermometers that are set up. There's one down there. There's one in another portion of the yard. So we'll know what the air temperature is. But we've also got here this soil thermometer. And this guy I find to be very accurate. Right now it's saying it's little under 40 degrees Fahrenheit in this location. I don't know if you guys can see that very well. Hopefully you can. But from all my temperature readings so far, the ground here currently is not frozen. Just about everywhere. There's maybe a little bit of pockets, different little spots in the yard that are frozen or are tough to get through. Maybe they're thawing. They haven't finished thawing right now. But for the most part, the soil just about everywhere in the yard is about 33, 34 degrees. But if I go somewhere like that, where there's rocks, right? I'll show you guys another spot that I took the soil temperatures. We're doing much better. We're in the 39, 40 range consistently. What struck me was that this location here with all these rocks piled up didn't seem to make too much of a difference with the soil temperature. If I went over here in the raised bed, this is just as cold as it is in the ground, believe it or not. So this is about 33, 34. This whole area is about 33, 34. These rocky areas here, this is where we get to 39, 40-ish range. This is really nice for these big trees. Even this tree actually is a little bit higher than 34, 32. It's somewhere, it's a little bit higher in the 30s, which is real nice, and I think has a lot to do with the straw that we're using here. We also have some rocks in there, but if I take the soil temperature right next to it, that's 32 degrees, 33 degrees. Again, not frozen. We're just above the freezing point. If I take the temperature along here, and you know what? This heats up real quick, right? The sun's shining on this. You got to come out here different times of day. I'm sure you're going to get different temperature readings, but I'm using this mostly as just a comparison, right? I want to see what this is right now versus what it is in the ground. And it seems like anywhere there's rocks, we're getting a clear advantage of at least 5 degrees. If I go out to the front of the yard to see the figs out there, we're barely getting anything, believe it or not. And I don't know, maybe I didn't give the thermometer a bit more time, but from what I could tell, these fig trees out here in the open, which are going to be exposed probably to the most wind, those are really, really cold. So the soil's even, you know, 33 degrees, which is not really what I want. I would prefer the soil at this point in the day. The sun's going down, right? We're on the west side of the house right now. This is the warmest. Well, it's not the warmest part of the day, but basically, I would prefer the soil to be quite warm right now so that by the time we get down to 8 degrees, it's not as extreme. But we'll come out here anyway. We're going to test. We're going to see what the soil temperature is in as many places as I can. I can stand it when it's that cold out. But also, we're going to take the temperature in these other places that are rocky and where the figs currently reside. So then that way, we'll know for sure what the temperature is. And according to this, the thermometer's been out here for maybe 20 minutes. It says it's 59 degrees out. But maybe that's 59 degrees at this soil level, right? If I raise this up higher, I'm sure it'll be much warmer. Maybe I should put this one somewhere out in the open so I can really get a really good temperature reading instead of a temperature reading down low on a rocky surface that's quite warm. But anyways, that's the experiment. I'm going to keep you guys updated on this, but I'm not going to come out here and do a video for you. So what you have to do is that I'm going to, if you follow me on Facebook or Instagram or Twitter, that's where I'm going to be posting the results of this experiment. I'm also going to be posting probably something on my website. We just created a website. It's rossratty.weebly.com. I have it in the description of this video. Go check out the website. Do a little bookmark there. I have a nice little blog that's there featured on the homepage. That way, for you guys who follow me on social media, you may have an attention span that's more than just a couple sentences, right? Twitter and Instagram really kind of limit what you can say on those social media platforms. Well, this way it's more long form. You guys get some more valuable information. I've already put out a nice, really nice blog post on growing figs in the ground. That's exactly related to this topic. So go check it out, guys, and I'll catch you all for the next one, right? See you tomorrow.